You ever heard a new song and it feels familiar? Like you've heard it before, but not like the chords or melody are the same. More like you've felt it before. There's a certain vibe to it that reminds you of something you've experienced in a way that's homey, comforting, kind of nostalgic. I had this last year when I first heard this song. I really love this song, but the first time I heard it, before the verse even started, it kind of hit me different. Immediately, I was transported back to my parents' living room as a kid, playing with Legos or whatever on the floor, and in the background from my parents' cassette player in the kitchen, I was hearing this song somehow. Now, obviously, this song didn't exist back then when I was a kid, so why did hearing it transport me back in time so vividly? Well, it's because the keyboard sounds at the forefront of You Are the Lord are doing this on purpose. It's an intentional choice designed to harken back to that earlier era of music. To help make sense of this, you really need to recruit an expert in these earlier eras of music. Luckily, I happen to know such an expert really well. Hey, Dad, it's David. How are you?
Hi, David. Good. How are you?
So, Pops, we're doing this video about this new worship song, but it sounds like the music that you guys would listen to when I was a kid around the house, like from Amy Grant, Michael W. Smith, Hillsong Worship. I just wanted to pick your brain and, like, ask you to talk about that music that I heard a ton growing up that you and Mom were listening to. What was it like for you guys to be hearing that kind of music for the first time as adults back then?
I grew up listening to what was titled back in the day Jesus music,
right,
with artists like Michael W. Smith and Amy Grant, and even some prior to that, Second Chapter of Acts. As I became a Christian in my teens, I started going to some concerts, including Michael W. Smith, Amy Grant, and others. And I'm still listening very actively to their music and going to their concerts. We used to subscribe to a cassette series, which is how we discovered Hillsong.
Yeah, that's awesome.
It was a subscription, and they sent us Shout to the Lord, which was their first album. And that's how your mom and I got hooked on Hillsong.
That's awesome. Well, we're all still playing their music today.
Indeed we are. Yeah, it's great music.
Well, that's awesome, Dad. Hey, I'm glad that I got to listen to that stuff growing up, and it's pretty cool that it's kind of still relevant now. So, hey, I love you.
Yeah.
So to really understand and harness what's going on here in You Are the Lord musically, from the keyboard, we need to look back at some earlier points of inspiration. Not just the playing style, more than that, it's the particular piano sounds used on these classic recordings. Back in the 80s, a couple pieces of iconic keyboard hardware became pretty dominant, specifically the piano and electric piano presets in these units. The first was the Yamaha DX7, which was released in 1983. This was the very first digital synthesizer that saw mainstream success, and it became prevalent and widely used across all genres of popular music. This synth used frequency modulation synthesis, abbreviated as FM synthesis, to generate all of its sounds, and no analog synths around at the time could sound just like it. The DX7 has tons of classic sounds, from brass to bells, synth bass, but maybe the most famous and popular sound was one preset, E-Piano 1. This was sort of an electric piano-inspired sound, but it had a bright, bell-like character to it that set it apart from the traditional Rhodes and Wurlitzer sounds that were common at the time. The second piece of hardware was maybe even more groundbreaking than the DX7. The Roland MKS-20 Digital Piano Rack Module, released in 1986, appears deceptively simple and might even sound a bit basic to a modern ear. But when it was released, it was the cutting edge of being able to get a responsive, usable piano sound without having to actually lug a real piano around with you on tour. The MKS-20 featured not just acoustic piano sounds, but also two electric piano presets. And all of these presets were widely adopted by musicians of the day across all genres. Which brings us to the nostalgia I mentioned earlier. Michael W. Smith at the Dove Awards in 1992. There's that piano sound. Oh, he looks great.
But this becoming is harder than it seems. feels like.
All that modulation too is so cool.
Looking for a reason, roaming through the night to find my place.
Okay, so man, what an awesome song. The piano tone is great. We'll talk about that in a second, but just the parts and the vibe, and honestly, man, the vocal delivery from that live version is really impressive. I genuinely love this song. So let's identify the piano sound that's here. I can't tell for sure, and there's definitely some processing going on to the piano, but let's start with the MKS-20 Piano 1 preset. Now, all these vintage piano sounds I've mentioned so far in the video are available in Sunday Keys, our worship keys template. So I'm gonna pull up the MKS-20 Piano 1. In Sunday Keys, it's called SK-20 Piano 1. All I'm gonna do with this preset is just turn off the tremolo effect, and let's see how it sounds. This is cool and definitely has the vibe, but I want a little bit more brightness and tackiness. Again, we don't know 100% what happened in the studio during the original recording, but a really common technique back in the late 80s and early 90s was to double track the keys parts to blend in multiple MKS-20 sounds. The original rack module could only play one at a time, but in the studio, you could double track it. So I'm gonna pull up the classic ePiano 2 preset from the MKS-20 and combine that with Piano 1. Let's hear how it sounds. Yeah, so this is feeling really good. And I'm just gonna talk about these parts a little bit because they are awesome. So we're in the key of B, but then we're gonna go D, A over C sharp, F, G, C, and then my favorite bit right here. So you get that right there, that walk up, and then we're right back in B. Back to D, F, G, C, and then right before we get to the chorus, we go somewhere completely different. We go G, A, and then we're looking for a reason. We walk it down. Ah, flat 7. There it is. There, man. Flat 7 again. what even are these chords? They're 4/6. And then 5. And then right back to the top. Man, they don't really write songs like this anymore. But I think it's coming back around. That was just fun to play and such a nostalgia trip. So, let's do another. This is a Christmas song. It's just, this is the most associated with that vibe to me of any song I've ever heard. Grown Up Christmas List by Amy Grant. Really a strong music video as well. Hallmark movie through and through.
Do you remember me?
Really nice melody doubling from that piano. And just such a drippy, sort of lush piano sound right from the beginning.
Well, I'm all grown up now.
Get a little choir in the background too. My mom loved this song on cassette tape, on repeat from Thanksgiving Day to the day after Christmas. And I just love it. I love the piano stuff. I love the vibe of the song. It's super fun. All right, man, this song has such a Hallmark movie vibe, even without the music video, and the music video takes it to another level. Let's dive into that really cool lead piano sound because it's pretty different from what we just did with the MKS-20. This ePiano is actually ePiano 1 from the DX7, at least to my ear. So I'm gonna load that in. notice what a big difference there is between this electric piano sound from the DX7 and the MKS20 sounds we used for the last song. Now again, it was really common to layer these sounds in, either with another preset from the same unit, or often with a Rhodes, or sometimes even with a real grand piano. Now to nail the vibe from this particular song, we can add in ePiano 2 from the MKS20. The combination of these two e-pianos is just so lush. The DX7 is all chime and metallic sparkle on the top end, and e-piano 2 from the MKS20 is providing some of the warmth in the body. Together, these two piano presets fill the room. Next up, see if you recognize this one. It's a bit more subtle.
Oh man.
This one takes me straight back to church as a kid. So this song was on repeat at my church from the day it was released until probably I was in junior high or high school. We wore this song out. And that piano riff is so recognizable to me. The whole vibe of the song is awesome. That piano with the little bit of melody stuff that's going on there just works so nicely. You immediately know what song it is if you've heard it more than once. Building up here. Really great chord change here to the flat 7. A big lift on the 5. So good. Now, this is an absolute classic. This song could really mark a new era of what would lead to modern worship music, in my opinion. Shout to the Lord was released in 1994 by Hillsong Worship, and it is still great today. Honestly, this whole album is a blast. Now, in terms of the key sound, here it's more subdued and natural. It sounds more like a real piano, but it's not. It's still a digital piano sound if you listen close. I don't know for sure what keyboard or workstation was used for this live recording. By 1994, when this song was released, there were multiple options out there for digital grand piano sounds. But we can use one of the MKS20 pianos to get in the ballpark. The key for this one is that there's not really any modulation going on. No chorus or tremolo, just a bit of reverb and the piano sound itself. So let's call up piano 1 again from the MKS20. So right away, we're already hinting on riffing at the verse melody line. And then it simplifies down once Darlene Check actually starts singing. And then as you get through the verse at the very end, you have this awesome lift. It's almost feeling like a modulation before you get to the chorus. So that's flat 7, walking it down, and then shout to the Lord. So it's the combination of the simple piano part with the modulation or those sort of color chords at the right moment that really define the song to me and give it all of its power. That little oomph right before you drop into the chorus is so satisfying even today. So across the span of just a few years in the early to mid 90s, this one style of sound was featured on not just these three songs, but tons more Christian music. And not just church music either, but countless popular songs too. This influence then, and the vibe that these piano sounds bring to any song, full of nostalgia, really beautiful sounds, is how we get here when this song is released in 2021. Immediately recognizable to me. So super nostalgic, and I'm just instantly keyed into what this song is going to do.
Everlasting light, your glory floods the earth.
You got quarter notes on the right hand from that E piano.
Oh my God.
Here's this lift right before the chorus part.
There's no one like you.
Got definitely something modern and recognizable going on here with what the rest of the band is doing around this piano part, but that piano sort of the through line of the whole arrangement. Okay, man, just such a great feel, and the choice to bring this, at this point, dare I say, retro sort of piano into the mix right at the top of the song was just such a great decision. Now, I think we can pretty much exactly replicate this one. I recognize it as the piano 2 preset from the MKS-20. So even there, I noticed little hints back to some of these earlier songs, Place in This World, the lift going into that chorus, or that sort of a shout to the Lord right there, that little turn right before we hit the chorus. You are the Lord. Awesome. So I gotta mention that this song is a collaboration between Passion and Maverick City. And I don't know for sure, but I'd guess that Maverick City and their team may have had a good bit to do with the production direction of this song, especially when it comes to this opening keys sound. These classic piano sounds faded out of use in a lot of popular music and CCM since the 90s, but MKS-20 and DX7 piano and e-piano sounds have remained a staple across a lot of popular gospel music ever since the original hardware was released. So while they might sound new, or maybe old and new to you if you play mostly CCM, folks who play primarily gospel music have been using these sounds to great effect like this for going on 2+ decades now. So it's pretty awesome to see bands like Maverick City bringing some of this genre depth to CCM, and it's really cool to see 80s and 90s influences popping back up in worship music too. Because honestly, that music was just tons of fun. It was often joyful, dramatic, maybe a little bit more technical, and I think we're really gonna see more of these sounds and ideas popping back up in emerging worship music over the next several years. But you don't have to wait for one of your favorite bands to do this before you experiment with bringing this vibe to your own worship band. So let's take something really simple, like the song, Great Are You Lord. Okay, so this is All Sons and Daughters, Great Are You Lord. Really simple song, one chord progression pretty much throughout the majority of the song. And it starts off with just like a maybe an upright or a small grand piano sound. You can see that red keyboard, so we have some ideas of where the sounds are coming from. But it stays really simple, really acoustic. And as it kicks in a little bit later on, it's almost hitting like a country song to me, because you got that slide guitar in there, the 6/8 sort of shuffle. So the original vibe of the song is great. Love it. Sounds awesome. But we could really easily, without changing a thing other than the piano sound itself, transport this song back 2 decades, from when it was released in 2013 to 1993. And it won't sound old. It'll sound, in a way, sort of brand new.
It's your breath in our lungs.
Thanks for watching, everyone. If you'd like to have these iconic piano sounds for your own worship team, they're all in the Sunday Keys template. If you'd like to learn more about it, check out the link in the description. Thanks to all the amazing artists whose work we were inspired by and referenced for this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment with your favorite 80s or 90s song that you recognize as using these classic sounds. I was remembering that one of the very first concerts I ever went to was with you. We went and saw Michael W. Smith together, like maybe in the late 90s.
I do remember that. So back in the day when we were driving in the car listening to a cassette tape of Michael W. Smith's I'll Lead You Home.
Mm-hmm.
And you love that. And you're back in the back seat in your car seat and you're just singing away, I'll Lead You Home. And it was great. It was great.
Oh, that's cool. We'll probably put this at the end of the video, Pops. That's how we're going to end it.
I think that's beautiful. Yeah.
Well, okay. Thanks for your time, Dad. I love you.
Yeah, glad.